بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. في البداية بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم، وكل أعمالكم سيرى الله أعمالكم ورسوله والمؤمنون، صدق الله العظيم. طبعا بنتقدم بكل الشكر والتقدير لأخي الفاضل الأستاذ الدكتور هشام الشيخ، أستاذ ورئيس قسم الإشعة بكلية طب جامعة، على الدعوة الكريمة وأتاحت الفرصة لي إن أنا ألتقي بزملاء أفاضل أعزاء واستمتع بعلمهم الغزير الأستاذ الدكتور عز عبد الحميد والأستاذ الدكتور هاني. وان شاء الله ربنا وفقنا، هم يتكلموا عن البيولوجي وانا هستفيد منهم. هم طلب مني الدكتور هشام اتكلم النهارده عن الكوفيد، وان شاء الله في لقاء ثاني برضه المحاضره كنت مجهزه الثانيه بتاع الكلينيكال كيس بريزنتيشنز، راديولوجيكال كيس بريزنتيشنز مره ثانيه باذن الله. الاول حته التاريخ بس، هذا المكان هو ده مقر اداره جامعه دانا حاليا، لكن بالتاريخ هذا كان قصر عباس باشا حلمي الثاني اخر خديوي في مصر، ابو الملك فؤاد. واثناء توجهه من القلعه، في اول استراحه كانت قصر محمد علي باشا في المانيال، الاستراحه الثانيه كانت قصر محمد علي باشا في شبرا الخيمه اللي هو حاليا على جزء من الجنان بتاعته كليه الزراعه جامعه عين شمس، وما زال القصر موجود تبع وزاره السياحه والاثار من الاماكن الرائعه شفناها. ولما عد على بنها طبعا قال له، كانت المنطقه دي كلها جناين، فقال لهم ايه الجناين دي بتاع مين؟ وكان حد له حاجه؟ قال له بتاع معالي. قال لهم خلاص بنبني سراي في الحته دي. قبل ما يروح على قصر المنتزه في الاسكندريه سنه 1936، هو اللي اسس قصر المنتزه في الاسكندريه. بعد سنتين القصر خلص، ما كانش قصور بقى زمان، كانوا بيسموها السرايا يعني. وكانت المنطقه دي متسميه على هذا المكان كفر السرايا. وكانت حواليها جناين. ولما نزل اول مره فيعني عاوز لحمه، بنى قصر يعني سرايتين، السرايه ديت والسرايه اللي جار منها اللي هي حاليا اداره المساحه في القلوبية، والاثنين حاليا دخلوا ضمن الاماكن الاثريه، لان اي مكان بيعدي عليه اكثر من 100 سنه هيئه التنسيق الحضاري بتعتبره مكان اثري. ده ال 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 كان مقر الاقامه له، ومقر الاقامه للوزراء والحاجات ديت اللي هو السرايه اللي جار منها اللي هي حاليا في وش مستشفى الجامعه مباشره. اول مره نزل عاوز لحمه، فجابوا له لحمه من الناحيه الثانيه من النيل. عجبته قوي اللحمه دي، منين؟ قالوا من منطقه قريه كده في الناحيه الثانيه اسمها كفر بنها. قال لهم لا، انعام خديوي اكراما للجزار اللي اكلني لحمه كويسه هنسميها كفر الجزار، المكان الموجود دلوقتي ده القصر من الداخل. ده بنفس المكان كده بنفس الهيكل، رغم ان عدى عليه السنين، وبعد الثوره اتحول لمدرسه ابتدائي، وبعدين مدرسه اعدادي، وبعدين كبرت لمدرسه ثانوي. انا شخصيا امتحنت فيه القبول اللي هو سته ابتدائي في هذا القصر، لكن ما زال بشبابيكه وهيكله. كوفيد ابديت، هتكلم الجزء الاولاني عن الفيرولوجي والباثولوجي اند باثوجينيسيس. هيستوريكال باك جراوند، الكوفيد از نوت ذا فيرست بانديميك، بس البانديميك سينس dates the first pandemic was believed 50 years before century، قبل ميلاد السيد المسيح. بعد كده السكند بانديميك مع بدايه العصر الاسلامي، وهو الفرق ما بين العصر ميلاد السيد المسيح وبدايه العصر الهجري، ميلاد العصر الاسلامي 541 ل 570. وعشان كده كان حديث الرسول عليه الصلاه والسلام للصحابة والمسلمين وقتها، إذا ظهر الطاعون في بلد أنتم فيها فلا تخرجوا منها. تباعد اجتماعي وحظر اللي احنا بنعمله دلوقتي موجود من العصر الإسلامي. وإذا ظهر الطاعون في بلد أنتم بعيد عنها فلا تدخلوها، عشان ما يحصلش انتشار للطاعون. وتوالت يعني البليج لغاية 1665 في لندن، و 1720 في مارسيليا، و1798 مع الحملة الفرنسية على مصر أيام كليبر اللي كان قائد، ونابليون بونابرت، وكانت من أسباب فشل الحملة الفرنسية على مصر ظهور الطاعون أو انتشار الطاعون بين الجنود الفرنسيين. بعد البليج الكوليرا، والكوليرا اختفت لكن بدأت تبان مع الحروب الأهلية في السودان، في الصومال واليمن. سبانيش فلو، ودي ابتدت ديت اللي اتعلمنا منها، ودي كانت الاصل بتاع الفيرولوجي كله، الاسبانيش فلو كانت الفيرست فايرال بانديميك، لان البليج والكوليرا كانوا بكتيريا. الاسبانيش فلو 1917 1918 وكانت H1N1 اباوت 20 to 50 مليونز This is worldwide. After that, Asian flu 1957 to 1958. لو لاحظنا كل بانديميك بيبان في نهاية سنة والسنة الثانية. زي ما قلنا كوفيد 19 هو كان مفروض يعني يخلص في 20 19 20 لكن هو ممتد معنا ربنا يستر الله أعلم الإمتى. هونج كونج فلو بعد 10 سنين 1967 1968 إلى أن وصلنا للكوفيد 2019 و 2020 اللي هو لأن دايما الفيرال انفكشن بتبتدي في نهاية شتاء في بداية شتاء وتنتهي مع الايه اللي هم في نهاية عام وبداية العام الثاني فصل الشتاء من 23 ديسمبر إلى 21 مارس من كل عام. إلى أول امبارح التوتال كونفيرمت كيسز في ايجيبت 167213 والديسز وصلنا لرقم كبير برضو خالص وصلنا قربنا على 100,000. الاول اوفر ذا وورلد المسجل طبعا ده المسجل كلمه المسجل لان ده يعني ده الحالات اللي عملت بي سي ار وكونفيرم لكن قدهم اربع او خمس اضعاف اللي ما عملش بي سي ار ما عملش المسحه واللي بيتعالج في العيادات. فالرقم ده ما نقولش ده صح لا ده في اربع اضعافه سواء عندنا او في العالم كله. فالاول اوفر ذا وورلد 103 مليون 362713 والتوتال ديسز وصلنا ل 2 مليون 244000 وربنا يعفو عنا ويشيل هذا البلاء والوباء. دي الصور في 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 ذات تايم في الاسبانيش فلو ما كانش المستشفيات مكفيه حولوا عنابر المصانع الى مستشفيات ميدانيه يحجزوا فيها العيانين ما كانش لا فيه نت ولا فيه بتاع فكانوا الهيئات الصحيه والدوليه بتمسك الميكروفونات وتنادي في الشوارع للناس تلتزم البيوت وممنوع الخروج والحاجات دي كلها ونفس الكلام الغرغره والمضمضه وغسل الايادي اللي هي الوقايه. ذا فيروس از الفيروس اختلف عن البكتيريا ان مالوش سيل ممبرين لكن له سيتوبلازمك ممبرين وفي جينوم وفي حاجات اللي هي بتعمل الفيرولنس بتاعته حاجه اسمها الهيم اجلوتينين اللي هو البيربل ده والجرين ده اللي هو النيورون منيديز اللي عندنا في الكوفيد حاجه تانية اللي هي السبايك بروتين والجينوم اللي هو الفيرال جينوم اللي هو جوه. طيب انو ذا تايبس اوف فايروسز ذا تو تايبس اوف فايروس دي ان اي فايروسز ودبل ستراند ار ان اي فايروس و اف ذير از ميرج بتوين اني تو different viruses yet produces new strain which may be very virulent. The double strand RNA with a single strand RNA with النوع اللي عندنا now الكوفيد is a single stranded RNA viruses وكل الفيروسز composed of five base pairs on which amino acid sequences will be attached. The five pairs اللي هم الادينين والسيتوزين والجوانوزين واليوراسيل والصينين. The cause of very virulent strains في عند زرار تو باثوجينيك تشينجز اوكيرز ان فيروسز انتيجينيك دريفت وانتيجينيك شيفت. انتيجينيك دريفت اللي هو ميوتيشن which produces minor change ويوجوالي اوكيرز افري 40 years. As we noticed before H1N1 في الاسيان فلو after 40 years at 1957-1958 بقت H2N2. What's meant by H1 and N1 that changes in the amino acid sequence in both the H hemagglutinin and the norm is the same. So H1N1 replaced after 40 years by H2N2. But after 10 years replaced by in the second part what's called antigenic shift. Major change, changes in the amino acid sequence, not the same in the H and the N. In H, maybe two amino acid sequence, but in N, three or different amino acid. So it reduces very virulent mutation, which occurred now in COVID-19. COVID means crown, in which there's strain and spikes from the wall of the virus. Beta corona, COVID related to, احنا عندنا alpha corona virus و beta corona virus related to the beta corona viruses اللي هو R single stranded RNA virus. الكورونا it is not now, الكورونا since 1962 first reported in bats, but in 2003 SARS severe acute respiratory syndrome reported in Wuhan برضو and Kuwait. At that time it was limited, not pandemic like now. But in 2013 Middle East respiratory syndrome, novel coronavirus appeared in Saudi Arabia during the period of pilgrim. Where they thought at that time in the virus transported from camels, transported from middle part of Africa to Saudi Arabia, and the virus transmitted from the camels to the human. At that time, this is my colleague, Professor Ali Muhammad Zaki, Professor of Virology and Microbiology in Ain Shams University. The same graduated in the same year with me. Was in Saudi Arabia and saw a patient, Saudi patient, 62 years old, severe pneumonia, admitted in the ICU. Investigations, all negative. Throat swab, lavage, all negative for bacteria. So he tried to do viral culture in his small lab in Suleiman Fakih Hospital. And appeared this virus, who is the first one to describe this crown and this, what is called COVID virus. Coronaviruses, alpha coronaviruses, about many strains. Coronavirus is not a single strain. Alpha coronaviruses produce cold, right, like common cold. But beta coronaviruses, about 230, the known strains up till now, but maybe more than 230 strains. The strains of beta coronaviruses, the first one reported that strain for the Middle East respiratory syndrome coronavirus, which is the strain for the SARS coronavirus, and that time it is named coronavirus 1, and the COVID now, when first described, named coronavirus 2. But in January 2020, WHO named it COVID coronavirus disease 19. This is the, in the red color, this is the virulent strain which produced COVID 2, اللي هو coronavirus. We saw in the last year different pathogenic forms and different clinical types. Maybe old patient, 70 years old, developed the coronavirus and the buzz unnoticed were mild manifestation. And the young patient, 20 to 30 years, developed the coronavirus severe form and within 5 days died. This is different strains and different HLA phenotyping of the human. And the response of the immune system against the virus is different from one patient to another patient. And this is the discrepancy in the manifestations of COVID in different patients. The virus usually transmitted from human to human by direct close contact. Transmission through droplet nuclei. The virus is very small, 5 microns. So transmitted during coughing, talking, loving. So if the distance between the patient and the contact less than 1 to 2 meters without protective measures like mask, so transmission is. About the affinity of the virus. COVID virus different from the common cold viruses or alpha coronavirus special affinity for a non-ciliated respiratory epithelial cell. The common cold viruses usually affect ciliated epithelial cells within 2 days due to shedding of the surface epithelium. It leads to hyperreactive airway. Usually patient after common cold usually complain of wheezy chest, viral induced pseudo asthma, not actual bronchial asthma. It is transient asthma until regeneration of the cilia develop and hyperactivity disappear. But that virus usually affects the latest part in the tracheobronchial tree, which is the alveoli. And especially in the alveoli, there are two types of cells. Type 1, alveolar cell, which is responsible for regeneration of the injured alveoli, and the type 2 alveolar cell, the type 2 monocyte, which is responsible for the secretion of surfactant. Surfactant is very essential to minimize the surface tension of the fluid lining the alveoli, so increasing distensibility and the compliance of the lung. And from the radiological point of view, why coronavirus presented early by ground glass appearance subpleural? The main pathology in the interstitium and in the alveoli. Not like the common cold and the bronchopneumonia, which affects the major airways and the central airways, but the COVID affects the peripheral airways. Right. The affinity not only for the non-ciliated respiratory epithelial cells, which is a type 2 pneumonocyte, but there are five sites all over the body. The goblet cells of the nose, and this is responsible for anosmia, the posterior third of the tongue, and this is responsible for loss of taste, absorptive part of the small intestine, the villi of the small intestine, and this is responsible for abdominal colic around the umbilicus and the diarrhea once, not like the diarrhea of colitis, frequent with continuous for 4 to 5 days, but diarrhea of COVID usually once or twice only. But all these associated with generalized bone ache and mild grade fever. طيب يبقى قلنا الطيب توني مونوسايت النوز التنج الابزوربتف بالت of the small intestine الاندوثيليوم of the blood vessels all over the body. And this is responsible for the COVID manifestations all over the body. الافكشن او الافينيتي يوجوالي تو سبيشال ريسبتور ان ذي سايتس ويتش از ذا انجيوتنسين كونفرتينج اكس روبتايتيز انزيم 2 اي سي 2 بريزنت ان ذي سايتس اند ان ذا سمول كابيلاريز وارتريولز اول اوفر ذا بودي ات از ديفرنت فروم اي سي 1 انجيوتنسين كونفرتينج انزيم تايب 1 which is present in the heart and the great vessels responsible for hypertension. So a hypertensive patient receiving an anti-ICE1, if developed coronavirus, instruct the physician not to stop the antihypertensive, continue antihypertensive, as an antihypertensive, like valsartan, close or block the angiotensin converting enzyme type 1, which is present in the heart and the great vessels, but the COVID affects the angiotensin converting enzyme type 2, which is present in the small blood vessels. The infectivity and incubation period, from 1 to 5 up to 10 days, different from one to another and according to the virulence of the organism. These are the receptors for the infections. A life cycle of COVID of coronavirus 1 or SARS 1 or SARS 2 لهم اخوات two the same. The virus usually attached by H spike protein to the cell membrane, so of the infected host producing cytosome. Inside the cytosome, the virus replicate, then attached to the messenger RNA to enter the nucleus of the cell host, producing many copies, million copies. So after that, it go out of the cell, infecting other cells all over the body. This is what I said. This is the virus attached by the spike protein to the cell membrane. Cytosome inside the virus, the viral genome attached to the messenger RNA inside the cell, produce million copies of the cell, then اكسوسايتوزس او تسبب. طيب why some patient infected and other not infected according to in the past year all of us known that children under 10 years of age cannot develop COVID but now after the mutation developed now children the new strains infected children why not infected before as all children receives vaccination for البوليو chicken pox MMR all these vaccines BCG vaccination reduce humoral and cellular immunity which block the receptors attached through which the virus attached to it so cannot infect it. يبقى ان وده الرول بتاع الفاكسينيشن بريديوس انتيبوديز تو بلوك السبايك بروتين فروم الاتاتشمنت تو ذا ريسبتور اوف ذا هوست. On the other half, this is not immunized, and this is the rule for instant plasma for the management of COVID. From the life cycle, we know the mechanism of action of some drugs. Drugs which inhibit the neuraminidase enzyme, which help the release of the viral genome. Neuraminidase inhibitors like oseltamivir and acyclovir will amantadine act through this mechanism. Other drugs act on the cell wall in that part, like the hydroxychloroquine inhibit the viral entry through the cytosome and also increases the alkalinity of the cytosome which block replication of the virus leading to the killing of the virus. The same mechanism of ivermectin. Also inhibit the viral entry and inhibit the messenger RNA so the virus cannot enter the host nucleus. What about the pathology of COVID? Until April 27 or 22, all of us all over the world cannot know the pathology. Until in Italy, Ministry of Health regulations allow the post-mortem examinations after the physicians wear the complete protective equipment and after doing post-mortem examinations for the died patients from COVID, they noticed the following. Microthrombi all over the small capillaries of the lung. This microthrombi is responsible for the early stage of hypoxemia and the patient cannot notice anything and called it heavy hypoxia. They like heavy wizard in COPD patient. Heavy hypoxia, the patient, if we measure the pulse oximetry, we notice the pulse, partial pressure of arterial oxygen saturation 90 or less than 90 and usually 96 to 97 without complaint. This is the early stage of before the ground glass, before the manifestation, before the mild fever, before the generalized ache, if we measure the pulse oxygen saturation, notice heavy hypoxia. After that time, the pathologist noticed the same as like DVT, the Virchow's triad, the roughness of the surface of the blood vessels, hypercoagulability, where the stages of the circulation. The Virchow's triad noticed the same pathology developed in the pulmonary capillaries and all capillaries of the body. And this is responsible for the manifestation of COVID in the lung and COVID in CNS and COVID in the skin due to a microthrombi developed all over the body. With paper appeared discussing that septic shock induced coagulopathy and disseminated intravascular coagulopathy, which occurs in malignancy, the same developed in COVID-induced coagulopathy. And this slide demonstrates the main pathology which occurred in COVID. On the left side, this is the healthy half of the alveolus. This is what I said before. This is the type 2, the monocyte type 2 alveolar cells, which produces surfactant. And this is the type 1 alveolar cell responsible for regeneration. And this is the alveolus with half of the alpha. On the other side, the virus attacked the type 2 alveolar cell. Destruction of the type 2 alveolar cells lead to decrease of surfactant. So surface tension of the fluid lining the alveoli increased. So leading to decreased distensibility of the lung, leading to hypoxemia. Also, microthrombi in the pulmonary capillaries. Injury of the surface, the virus attacked the endothelial cells اللي عليها الريسبتور. الانجيوتنسين converting enzyme leading to injury to the endothelium and the hypercoagulability stage of the blood leading to microthrombi. The injury of the blood vessels leading to what is called the vasoplegia. Any injured vessel usually due to the effect of the clotting factor will be little constrict, but here no constriction, so leading to more vasodilatation, the vasoplegia, oozing of the edema fluid in the interstitium. This is what is called alveolo-capillary membrane. This is the surface of the alveolus, which is the surface of the capillaries. This alveolo-capillary membrane usually 0.07 micron. But in COVID now, the thickness may be up to 4 or 5 micron, decreasing the diffusion of the blood gases through it, leading to hypoxemia. يبقى في عندنا في decreased compliance و decreased elasticity of the lung بالإضافة ل increased alveolar capillary membrane, all the triad leading to marked hypoxia which developed in patients with COVID. As regarding the gross pathology, they noticed varying degrees of lung solid changes, alveolar damage. If exudations are composed of monocytes and macrophage, alveolar interstitium, as we said, is marked with vascular congestions and edema, infiltrations of monocytes and lymphocytes and the vascular hyaline membrane thrombi. Also, lungs are laden with hemorrhagic and necrotic foci. Well, hemorrhage, the destructions of RBCs with destructions of mononuclear cells leading to elevation of serum ferritin, one of the diagnostic criteria for lab diagnosis of COVID, increased serum ferritin. Hemorrhagic infarction, the bronchi are filled with mucus and mucus plugs. On electron microscopy, cytoplasmic variants, even a virus may be noticed in electron microscopy examinations of the lung tissue, are observed in the bronchial epithelium and the type 2 alveolar epithelium. Spleen, hilar lymph nodes, and the bone marrow. The spleen is usually, if there is evident shrinking, spleen and lymphocytopenia with focal hemorrhagic necrosis in the spleen. Macrophage proliferations and phagocytosis. Lymph nodes are found with sparse lymphocytes and occasional necrosis. Why sparse lymphocytes in the spleen and the lymph node? And what is the cause of lymphopenia in the blood picture during the diagnosis of COVID? All lymphocytes are trapped at the site of infection, what is called compartmentalization. So lymphocytes disappear from the peripheral blood and from the lymph node or the spleen. The CD4 T helper cells and CD8 T suppressor cells are present in reduced quantity in the spleen and the lymph nodes. Then cytopenia is identified in the bone marrow due to affection of the virus. What about the clinical picture? The fever, low grade fever, 37.5, 37.6, maximum 38. But if secondary bacterial infection developed after 4 to 5 days, fever elevated. Dry cough as affected in the interstitial. Against or in comparison to the bacterial pneumonia or other viral bronchopneumonia, the main pathology inside the alveoli, as in the first stage of pneumonia, stage of congestion, stage of hepatization, stage of gray hepatization, stage of resolution, all pathology inside the alveoli. So the patient of typical pneumonia, dry cough only 1 day, وبعد كده productive cough, excessive cough, rusty sputum here in that disease, in the COVID, dry cough. All over the period of the viral infection, dry cough until secondary bacterial infection developed. Mild اكسبكتوريشن ابير فاتيج وذ مين كومبلينت ذا سترونجست كومبلينت فاتيج اند جنرالايزد بون ايه سبوتم برودكشن مينيمال وشورتنس اوف بريست بسوبنومونيك اند ذا فيرست و very important component is shortness of breath without wheezy chest and we noticed many prescriptions bronchodilator as the patient complain of shortness of breath it is not bronchial asthma and prescriptions of bronchodilator is very dangerous this is the chart for the complaint it is the main complaint manifestation all over the body skin manifestation like urticaria, eruption, CNS manifestation. The patient may present with vertigo for the first time in his life. Vertigo with fatigue and generalized equal COVID until proved otherwise. A patient presented with cerebrovascular stroke and we noted three patients from that cerebrovascular due to microthrombi in the brain leading to transient ischemic attack. In the heart, arrhythmia, acute coronary syndrome due to the microthrombi in the coronary vessels, acute myocardial infarction. One of the commonest cause of sudden death in COVID patient, either during the attack or maybe after complete resolution, as the hypercoagulability is present for about 2 months. So when we do D-dimer and when it's D-dimer is less than 0.5, that we repeated after 5 days. If more than 0.5 to 1, we prescribe for the patient from the first day, anti-activated factor 10 anticoagulant, either injection or oral, and we continue it for at least 45 days up to 2 months to avoid the post-COVID hypercoagulability state. If more than 0.2, if more than 1, we give therapeutic dose of anticoagulant. As regarding the CNS, well, also in the chest, all of us know the manifestation of the chest. In the kidney, affected kidney, acute kidney injury. In the liver, elevated liver enzymes. This is the skin manifestation. Type, what investigation we do? CBC, ESR, CRB, serum ferritin, serum D-dimer, LDH, nasopharyngeal swab, rapid test. Rapid test to diagnose. In the first 5 days, IgM, if elevated, one of the diagnostic criteria, but not sure. So why we don't mention here chest X-ray and CT scan, which is very essential. But after the manifestation of cough, then maybe the COVID is outside the chest and CT scan cannot manifest anything. If the patient presented with abdominal colic and diarrhea, so when we do CT scan of the chest, no manifestation, and no radiological manifestations if COVID outside the chest. This is a curve for the appearance of rapid test and IgG and decline of IgG at the site of infection from 1 to 5 days. This is the incubation period, and at the 5 days start to appear IgM. This IgM, when appeared from the 5 to 7 days, start to peak at 14 days and decline at 21 days. The IgG, which is the PCR as regarding the swab, لو خدنا PCR, PCR up to 30% may give false negative. Up to 30% of patient, PCR may be negative. Up to 30%. False negative also, there are false positive due to viral remnant after the patient clinically improved, lab improved, but still PCR is positive. This is viral remnant, not actual infection. Type IgG appeared on the day of 14 and continued reaching its peak at 28 days and declined from 35 up to 2 months disappear from that site and from the patient. We know the rule of vaccination. Vaccination usually give antibodies simulating infections appeared. شو يعني appeared in that day, in the 14th day, وعشان كده we give booster dose after 21 days, reached its peak and continue for up to, sorry, and will continue for up to 2 to 3 months maximum. Myself, I noticed 5 patients developed reinfection after 2 months. First was with GIT, the second infection was the chest, how the first infection was the chest, the second infection, reinfection was GIT or CNS. Like, as regarding time and we learn from our professors now, this is the radiological manifestations. Either early ground glass, subpleural, usually basal, or this manifestation typical, this is the ground glass and this is the crazy baby. Radiological signs basognomonic of COVID. What about the prognosis? There are some diseases, some comorbidities which increase the side effect or increase the bad prognosis. If the patient with COPD developed COVID, the prognosis is bad. Ischemic and valvular heart conditions. Patient with receiving immunosuppressive drugs or develop the disease which produce immunosuppression, like HIV, malignancy, ال severe obesity, ال uncontrolled diabetes mellitus, the patient was chronic kidney disease or chronic liver disease, the prognosis is bad. The signs of bad prognosis, the CBC. If we notice lymphopenia, azinopenia, thrombocytopenia, pancytopenia, is a sign of bad prognosis. Increased interleukin 6, which is one of the يعني imminent signs for increased cytokine storm. And if we noticed increased parameters and we did and we do interleukin 6 level was elevated, this is the indication for tocilizumab anti IL-6, which down regulate the hyper immune state. Increased the serum ferritin, increased the CRP, increased the dimer, increased the serum troponin, and increased the serum LDH. الايرلي ورننج ساين اللي انا اتكلمت عليها دلوقتي, الكلينيكال تايبس بنقول ده الكوفيد ده مايلد ديجري او مودريت او سيفير او كريتيكال. المايلد ده اللي هو هوم ايزوليشن وعلاجه سهل, والمودريت اللي بدا الاوكسجين ساتوريشن عنده ينزل عن 97 but still up above 93%, but if الاوكسجين ساتوريشن below 92 it is considered severe patient. If the heart rate and respiratory rate elevated, respiratory rate more than 35, heart rate more than 100, hypoxia less than 90, it is a critical patient and need ICU admission. This is the chart for the resident. Last slide. دكتور هشام, لو نخلي بعد كده البروفيلاكسز والتريتمنت في سيشن ثاني عشان ادي فرصه ان انا استمتع بالزملاء الدكتور عزله والدكتور هاني. فاخر سلايد, الكورونا فيروس از ان ار ان اي سنجل ستراندد فيروس, ات از ريليتد تو تايب بي بيتا كورونا فيروس. In 2003, produced the SARS 1 in China and Kuwait. In 2013, produced the Middle East respiratory syndrome in Saudi Arabia. It has a special affinity to non-ciliated cells. It reduces microthrombi in small blood vessels, increased the elastance and decreased the lung compliance are the main pathological changes responsible for hypoxemia in COVID-19. And thank you very much. ولو سمحت لنا في اللقاء كم يوم السبت.